guys, here we are. Faithful workouts. Let's get started here. All right, guys, I've got my friend Judy here with me, and we are going to be doing this beginner cardio and strength. I'll be showing a lot of moves in the chair, so if you ever need to sit down, you do so. But we're going to get marching. You know, it's important that you meet your body where it's at. If you've taken time off during COVID and you haven't been working out and you're starting back up, go easy. If you've been working out a lot and you feel like you can push it, then push it. But have fun and be thankful for every exercise you can do. We're not going to worry about what we can't do, okay? 4, 3, 2, we're going to do a heel dip. Heel. Good. Now a nice big flex on that foot. Kind of get that calf stretched out. If you're in a chair, try to have good posture. If you can sit up and not use the back, awesome. But if you need to lean back, you do it. 4, 3, 2, we're going to reach across. Reach back. Reach back. Kind of bring a big twist. Two more. All right, other side. Reach, kind of twisting over. Try to remember to pull your stomach muscles in, keeping your core nice and strong. 4, 3, 2, we're gonna reach overhead, other side. Reach, reach. Good. 4 more, feel that stretch come down your side. 2, other side. We need to do this dynamic stretching before we work out. 4 more, 4, 3, 2, we're just gonna kind of now twist, twist, slightly over as I hit my hand into the pine tree. Good, 4, 3, 2, all right, we're gonna start with strength. We're gonna get a band, or you can use weights, okay, either way. Now in a chair, you put it on your feet. You want to make sure your heels are firmly on the ground, shoulders back and down. When you're standing up, have knees slightly bent, okay? Good posture. Up, 2, 3, 4, down. Up, 2, 3, 4, good. Up, down. Two more like that. One more. All right, come halfway down. Hold it. Can you feel that? Just holding it. Good. We've got 8, 7, 6, 5, 2, 1. All right, take it off. We're going to bring it out in front of us. You could do a step-out squat with this or just focus on upper body. Pull back. Good. I hope Judy's an inspiration for you. She has been working out. Like, when did you first start working out? Not just with me, but like, you worked out your whole life, or?
When I was about in my 30s.
In your 30s, yeah.
Before that, I was a real happy kid.
So yeah, she started working out in her 30s, and now she's 40, right?
Yeah. No, it's 40 years later.
Yeah, yeah, she's in her 70s. Is that crazy? 4 more. 3, 2, 1. All right, we're going to put a handle or two in our hand, right this, bicep by ear, and reach it up. With my ponytail. That's the only thing about this move. Good posture. You can keep that bicep by ear. So we're going to kind of alternate a song of strength, a song of cardio. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's switch sides. Right here, lift. So important we work all these muscles. You know, your bicep and your tricep work together. So you want to strengthen them both. They call them opposing muscles. muscles. So we're going to work these opposing muscles. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Take it behind you. Right here. Push it out. So if you don't have a band, you could be using weights right now. If you don't have either one, just keep moving. That's the big thing. So we're doing a 30-day fitness challenge. You can sign up at the link I have in this post or in our bio. But it's so good. It's just inspiring you to get moving every day for at least 15 minutes. Two more. All right, sip of water, and then we're going to do some cardio. You take it at your pace, and maybe you're just doing a tab. That's awesome. Or maybe you're just doing your arms. You do what you can do, okay? Kick it out. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Let's jump rope. The loops, the circle, yeah, yellow and green. Here, if you want to come into kind of a low squat, you can, or just stand and push it out. External rotation. Good. We got this. Two more, one more. Okay, so what you're gonna do now is hold the loop this way and grab it with your other hand. This arm stays straight, this arm pulls back. Hold, back, hold, back, hold, hold. Good. Four more. That's it. You can do this with weights as well. Two, one. Now I want you to take this hand and bring it now to hold onto your chest or shoulder. This hand goes through. You see that? Okay. Push it out and down. Now an option is this, little half squats. All right? But it's a big tricep. Push. Push. Got this. Two more. All right, just march or jog for a little bit. Four, three, two. Looking good, Judy. Looking good. Hi, everybody. It's so fun to see that you're here working out with us. Squat, guys. Being able to get up off of the toilet, off the couch. It's critical. That can keep you out of assisted living, this one motion. So work on it. If you can't get all the way up, just use your hands a little bit to help you and come to here. Four more. Hi, Leo. Three. Two. One. All right, right here. We're punching. Twist your core. You need to go slower. You go slower. Work that core. Eight. Seven. Six. you can pull yourself up on, that can help. Judy's going to put a loop on her ankles. I'm going to get a band like this. I'm going to put it underneath. Now, if you don't have this, just using your hands can be good. All right, so Judy, we're going to take steps out to the side. Step, step, step. Good. So I'm working the outside of my thighs. Now you need to be on the very front part of your chair to do these. Push out, push out. Good, come on. An option, keep going. If you do have that loop, you can take it here. And just do this. You keep going there, Judy. You can just do push outs, all right? Okay, now we're going to do it where Judy's going to put it on one ankle and we're just going to push forward. Push it out. Now you can do this without a loop, guys. It's hard. Push hard. I'm working our quad, hip flexor. That's it. 8, 7, 4, 3. Switch it over. Go. Great isolation exercise for this quad and this hip flexor. Sit up strong. Yeah, balance, guys. So important that we work on it. It's one of the five pieces of a total body workout. So we got cardio, strength, core, balance, and then flexibility. 8, 7, 4, 3, 2, 1. So Judy's going to take it down and she's going to push back. Okay? Now if you're in a chair and you're able to stand up, you can hold on to it and push it back. Okay? If you're not able to do that, I want you to just come here. I'm going to put it underneath the arch of my foot. Okay? So I am arch of this foot and pull my knee back in. And I'm going to lift and pull back. That's hard. I just made this up. I've always tried to work hamstring in a chair, and it's so hard. This is awesome. 3, 2, 1. Guys, you could do this sitting at a desk. No one would even know what you're doing under there. Okay? Pull back. We're switching feet. Pull back hamstring curl. That's it. Five more. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're going to put on both. We're going to go ahead and do those step outs again. So I'm going to put that right underneath of my knee. Good. You got this. 8 more, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're going to take it off. We're going to do calf raises. It's important we strengthen our calves, okay? So within the chair, push your hands, kind of push your weight into your heels, and then she's just going up and down. So I'm pushing and using my own body weight to work my calves. Toes out, heels in. So last night, I got a cramp. Has anyone ever had cramps? Oh my goodness. I can still feel it. It was in my calf. get to the side of a chair, you can do it right here as well, okay? Just pulling it out a little to the side. Feel your oblique engaging. Four, three, two, switch sides. Keep your arm nice and strong. That's it. Four, three, two, right here. Good. Four, three, two, arms come up. Four, three, two, and march it down. How are you feeling? Doing good? Four, three, add an arm up. Up, up, push, push, push. Four, three, two, one more, and kick it out. Four more, four, three, two. All right, we're going to get some water and we're going to go into our core. Working some core and then we'll do some stretching as well. Okay. Hi. Now standing up, it's real important that you don't move from your hips down. Take a wide, kind of strong stance. Arms up. In a chair, you kind of have to have your legs a little bit further apart. We're going to double it now. Double. Double. And I'm really using these obliques, whether you're standing or sitting. Good. That's it. Working your shoulders too. Four more. Four. Three. Two. We're going to go singles now. Four, three, arms come in. Twist, twist. Big twist. So we're going to put one leg out. I'm going to just pull out over a little bit there. So I hope that you see, guys, sitting in a chair, you can get a great workout. Standing up, great workout. Keeping things a low impact, you can definitely still get your heart rate elevated. Switch sides. And the big thing is that you do something. Again, that's why we're doing this 30-day fitness challenge. Because I believe consistency is so critical. It's really important that you just keep moving. Come up, let's pull our arm across. I would say, you know, I've been working out consistently for 36 years. And I don't do like the hardest workouts. I don't push myself to the point of like, I'm absolutely dying, but I consistently do something. Switch sides. And one, I think that's part of the reason why I haven't really had any injuries from all my years of teaching. I listen to my body, but I keep moving. I do something almost every day. Come up. And the reason why, because I think asking yourself why is a really important thing. Like, Judy, why did you come today?
Because I
need
to get my body moving. I feel it when I don't.
And what, so... Why do you want to keep your body moving?
Because otherwise I'm going to stand up sitting in a chair somewhere looking at people and going, I wish I could do that.
Yeah. Because you don't want to be sitting in a chair watching people live. You want to be able to live. And being able to live means having a body that has some strength and energy. So when you ask yourself that question, why am I exercising? I want you to ask yourself, three times why, and keep peeling back the layers upon layers. And you know what you might come to is a place where you discover, I'm doing this really for other people because I want them to love me, and I think I need to be skinny for them to love me. That, you know what, that's awesome that you come to that realization. Tricep stretch. It just means, you know what, you need to think about that. Is there a reason, how can I help myself with that desire for people pleasing? But you also might come to a place where, you know, I want to live life to the fullest, switch arms. And I know that for me to be able to go and do the things I love to do, I need to take care of my body. If I want to be Christ's servant while I'm here on earth, I need to take care of my body. Hands up. In a chair, we put our legs out. Standing up, you just stand. Come forward, reaching, and then round those hands down. Inhale up. We're going to do that three more times. So ask yourself why. And when you get to that place, let it really encourage you to either dig deeper into your motives and how you can change them, or how you can use that motive to get you to exercise when you really don't feel like it. One more. Right there. All right, guys. Thanks so much. Thanks, Judy. That was a fun workout, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And let's keep moving every day, okay? You'll be thankful you did it. You can sign up again for the fitness challenge. The link is in the bio, or you can go to the post.